Hello everyone, welcome to Scorched Earth Toys at anymoon.com's transformation guide for Bandai's 160 scale DX VF-27 Renewal Toys. One of the things I've always liked about these DX VF-27 toys is that they are fairly simple to transform. To begin, there is a peg that is holding the leg and wing together. So you're just going to apply pressure upward on the wing, right around the engine, and it will pop open. You'll see that peg free of that slot. Now all you need to do is pull your legs outward and bring the knees down. You don't want those knees scratching any paint. And then you can bring the leg down at the hip joint here. You might want to apply a little pressure upward at the intake area. Otherwise, as you can see right there, you might disconnect the hip, and you don't really need to do that at this point. And then you have your full GERWALK joint there. So there you can see, if it does come unattached, you can just put a little pressure upward and reattach. Pull down on the feet and open them up like so. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and remove the shield. All you have to do is pull down and it comes right off. Okay, bring your little winglets down to be alongside the intakes. All right, now we're gonna free the arms. So what you wanna do is get your intakes disconnected and swing the plane forward, thus giving you full access to the arms. And you can see there's just kind of a swing mechanism that just allows you to pull the arm outward away from the body a little bit, and then just rotate it around like so. Once your arms are free and out, there's a little connector right here that you're going to want to bring down. You get your intakes back into the position they belong in. I guess it's right behind the intakes on this toy. So you get these legs locked into place. And then you bring in this connector piece and bring it behind the crotch. And there are two little slots in the back of the crotch, or it's, I guess, one wide slot. You can see there. So you just bring it in. Pegs into place. And you're almost there. Finish up with the arms, you're gonna bring the shoulders out. You're gonna extend the arms down. And you're going to attach the shield to the left arm. Now, I'm not gonna bother showing it to you, but this would also be the point where you replace these knife hands, if that's what you've still got on the toy. With either some fixed post hands or the articulated hands. Okay, so all that's left to do at this point is to go ahead and bring your wings down, and now you're in GERWALK mode. Continuing on to battroid mode, begin by bringing these fins downward and curling up your outside wings. All right, now we're going to bring the nose cone down. So just open up these landing gear doors and fold the nose cone down. And the instructions make it pretty clear you want this to be a flat surface in the front. So don't push the nose cone back too far or not enough. Get it to be flat like that. All right, before we bring the legs down, you got to make sure that you disconnect the GERWALK support joint in the back, and then since these legs are so loose, they'll pretty much just drop down on their own, which at this point is what you want. Just straighten out the GERWALK joint. And you're well on your way. Before moving on to the chest area, let's bring the legs back up and bring the kneecaps like so. Alright, now we break the toy's back and elevate the chest. So to break the back, you just apply a little downward pressure right behind the cockpit. Does that. Okay, my shield fell off. That's obviously not a big deal. And then you just lift up like this, and you've got the chest now exposed. Okay, your toy will look something like this now. You can lean it forward, bring these wings up, and then you've got a finger here. You bring the back down. There's a little swivel right behind the shoulders. Just bring that down. And now use this finger to push upward on the head from beneath. And then you're going to use your fingers to free up the head even further. And hear a little click. Your head will become exposed like so. This is where things get a little scary as far as scratching paint goes. You can use your finger and pull up on the head. You'll free a trap door that brings the whole head upward. Then you're going to bring up the nose of the plane and swing back the chest so you can get the nose in that chest cavity. And then you're going to worry about the front of this chest scraping that nose cone. So that's a big fear for just about everyone who transforms this toy. If you do things just right, you should be able to bring it down without scratching anything. But it's a very, very tight fit. And you'll note while I was doing that, the crotch panel fell off. That's a pretty common complaint already about this toy, that these panels don't stay on particularly well. It's just a little bit of a nuisance during transformation. Okay, now we're going to bring the head down and pop it into place. And we're going to actually push down on these shoulders to free them from the little plastic housing, their peg. There's a peg that goes inward from the shoulder into a plastic housing. By pressing down, we've freed that peg up. And we can now pivot the shoulder upward. And we've now freed up these panels on the sides of the neck so that they don't have to be at the exact same angle as the front of the chest. So it should look something like that. At this point, you've got the world's tallest battroid mode. So to continue, we're going to expose these metal pegs and bring them up into these black slots. Start by swinging the shoulders back. You want to create as much clearance as you can up at the top. Then bring your leg forward and continue to bring them forward. Now you want actually to rotate on that metal peg, so just bring it down. Same thing on this side. Bring that shoulder in. Bring that around. So now you've got your legs rotated where they need to be. Shield fell off, no big deal. Once they're in position, you probably still have to do a little bit more rotating here, but you can just push them into that black slot. Now you want to make sure the metal of the leg is not rubbing against the painted sides of this hinge mechanism. Apply pressure inward and you'll hear a pop. And that means everything is as it should be. Okay, so what we need to do next is pop the crotch forward like so. That once that's done, you're going to want to angle the legs back a little bit so you can get a more natural standing position, and you'll probably need to adjust the feet and do some minor adjustments. All right, so now you're in battroid mode, but the toy might have a tendency to want to straighten itself up. Not that extreme, but just a little bit, which reduces that forward crotch lean that the toy's supposed to have. So what Bandai's done is they've given us a little extra piece that you can slip in underneath. There's a little black peg there. So you just use that as your slot. And then there's a little slot in the back with a little peg on the top. So this piece goes in between those two. A little easier to do without a camera and lights. Okay, like so. So now the toy can't lean back any further than Bandai intended it to do. The final step of transformation is to take the included chest intake filler pieces, and I've already plugged in this one. You have the little recessed bit towards the outside of Batroid. You just kind of plug it in. There's a little peg on the other side. And there you go. Now you're in Batroid mode. You may need to adjust how high your shoulders are and your hip kibble. But that's about it. Thanks for viewing. Check out my full review on anymoon.com.